Hi, I'm David Nee, and now I'll start my thesis presentations with the topics of the circular economy of architecture, followed by the proposal of metaric.
Meta means the metabolic change in social environment that influenced the architecture. Rick means vessel, material component that used to form the space. So what I emphasize here is an independent life cycle of the material that is divided from the building life cycle. Building life cycle begins the moment construction starts, where material life cycle started long before we extract it from the earth. But often, building and material are perceived as one. Because of that, when the building hits the end cycle, so does the material. And eventually both end up in the landfill. That is just one example of the linear economy system. Packaging turns into waste after product is consumed because no one holds the responsibility to own it. And built environment alone has contributed a tremendous amount of waste. Because often we tend to change new packaging when the product is not satisfied. And in this case, the product is our space. The linear system has existed for centuries, but was ignored until the waste and carbon emission has become a noticeable threat to the environment. And that is where a new mindset hits in. The circular economy. A different way to approach Earth resources to rethink a system of package design that can be reused over time. Unlike recycle, it is designed to be repaired easily and redistributed without involving high energy to process the recycled waste. The final goal is simple, to remove disposal waste from the supply and demand chain. So that opens up a new possibility to think how circular economy can influence architecture. Often we thought buildings are eternal, so it is designed that way. But many didn't realize that building has a lifespan too. End cycle of a building isn't always because of the structural failure, but also because of the paradigm shift of demands due to the changes in social environments. The building that was built on the same year might not result in the same value, but the value is justified by the need, and sometimes it is just because the content is less favorable to the demand of its area. And all it needs is to move on and find the demand that adores it. But how can the building find its value if it is tied to the ground? So that inspired the idea of breaking building into smaller parts through component-based design. Small enough to be relocated easily according to demands. Then invest on a small component will be more worthy because the value is maintained with a constant demand chain compared to a solid building that might degrade over time. The building, however, is non-existent without material, so it is just land or the material bank for the investor to park their properties to generate profit, and everything will operate as a form of rental because at the end of the day, users just need the space, but not to own material. Gradually, this practice could generate a network of supply chain through small component trading, and that brings up another challenge. Compatibilities. The first design of Lego brick molded in 1949 still fits fine with any new Lego brick design today. It is made possible because of the consistency in grids and rules behind the interlocking systems. So we adopt this idea into the component design of the building through a three-dimensional recursion rule to set a common scale and size to all components with a compatible joint, so the column can be used as beam, floor as wall, or the window as railing. Additional attachment can also be equipped on certain components to enhance their strength for loads, so that component will have more than one function to increase the chance for demands. And the beauty of it is the efficiency of mass production of a single design, a single jointing, but for many purposes. And we bring this concept into the design of an office. The small office, flexible office. We combine the typology of the co-working with the conventional office block for the small-scale pioneers that are collaboration-based, so they are more receptive to the idea of space sharing. You can choose between making your office public or private, or you can have both, all within a single set of recursion grids. The site is located in an urban setting of Medini, facing to the lake and adjacent to the commercial lots. The intention is to maximize public space and interaction, so we divide the movement between pedestrian and vehicle into two zones. The circular office and warehouse will be located adjacent to the access road, so it functions like a custom checkpoint for the material before they assemble on site. Then we connect the site to the surrounding to enhance its exposure physically and visually, and adding more value to the urban oasis by bringing out all the service area to the first floor to create a seamless connection from one end to the other end on the ground. The forms are defined through the hierarchy of scale that seemingly ascends from the lake and allowing more views from every towers to the north. A single unit is adequate for a micro-enterprise and can stack up to a maximum of 8 units to the size of a medium enterprise. Expansion can either be done separately or they can negotiate with the adjacent unit if it is occupied. If the agreement is accepted, unit swapping can be done in just 2 days over the weekend. However, each enterprise can only expand up to 2 units on a single level to maintain the diversity and welfare of each party. So in order to achieve rapid relocation of 2 officers in 2 days, every components are designed to be assembled and disassembled easily. The time frame will be determined by the workforce and installation time of each component. Since the nature of the building is designed to change constantly, supportive mechanism will also be the part of building utility to ease the work. Each unit will be granted a maximum of 6 grid to be expanded. Installation will start from the inner parts to the facades, so to avoid damage to the component during installation. Heavier components such as structural grid or hollow slab will be assisted by attachment that mounts on the upper structural frame. Every component are designed to be mechanically joined instead of chemical joined, so dismantle and relocation process will be made easier when the demand shift, without causing damage to the material, therefore no disposal. Smaller component will have a simpler connection that can be assembled by the user when it is just a minor alteration. Circuit system is also designed into a series of modules that can be connected in the form of grids to simplify and shorten the wiring work too. And in total, it will take approximately 8 hours to complete the installation, with 3 workforce and a conversion of 520 to the largest of 775 square feet. Office swapping involves 2 units. That means everything will be duplicated, including disassemble process. But if we divide the task into 2 days within a week, the work schedule of each day will roll back to 8 hours. From the look of it, you won't notice the boundary of offices because expansion are interlocked in all directions. But what we can notice is a social culture of working environment that is different throughout the impression of unit layout. Some are more substance, where the other are more receptive. So the architecture impression could also somehow represent the company image to attract opportunity and collaboration with like-minded party. But that result in the complexity of variations. So a component database will be developed to record the quantity of components installed on each unit. This database could also integrate with software for the user to test and visualize the layout on the screen before they send the order to the management warehouse. Units with the same owner will have the option to link the office through a set of personal staircase module small enough to fit into a unit upon installation. As for the service systems, riser will channel directly into the unit from the outmost layer of the building rather than the horizontal distribution from the inside, so to maximize the flexibility for future changes. Layout of service systems are also rearranged to have as minimal contact as possible to every floor. The riser will be designed in the form of module as well, so that it can be disassembled during the extraction of structural component on the event of building shrinking in future. In other words, it could also be the event of structural maintenance in case we have new upgrades in the future too. And after all, the life cycle of the material will have more defined purpose that only cross paths with the building life cycle. So when the building cycle ends, it will continue its journey with limitless possibility, not only to modern buildings, but also applicable to conservations, adaptive reuse, or rapid transformation for demands during the pandemic outbreak. And the best of all, the more often a material is reused, the more embodied energy it could recover every time it completes a cycle. And suddenly, material will be so valuable that everyone wants to take good care for its reusability. Until that point, people will no longer associate property to just area or volume, but also preservation of earth resources that are limited and valuable.